Hey guys, what's up? It's Pixelated Apollo. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you guys are doing well, like always. And welcome back to another gruesome battle in Medieval Kingdoms Total War 1212 AD. This one is a 2v2 siege battle, but this one's not going to play out like your standard siege battle. The armies are set on large, so each player could potentially bring up to 40 units per army. Also, I'm going to be showing up as reinforcements, so my army is headed back this way, forming up, so I cannot show up until 10 minutes after the battle begins. So we have a bit of a, you know, a peace treaty here, just letting my troops get, you know, get back here without them being harassed. Now, in this battle, Jackie Fish, he's going to be defending the main castle here. He is commanding the Holy Roman Empire, and I am commanding the Duchy of Serbia. So, the Serbians moving back here with those very colorful shields. And then the two attacking armies, we have England, and we have the Duchy of Burgundy. So pretty solid forces, pretty good factions in today's battle. Let's go ahead and check out these army comps, and then we can get this one started. I believe the bombardment begins at 49:56. So we do have a couple minutes here to check out these armies. Let's start with my Serbian force here. So it's consisting of two units of the Serbian auxiliary swordsmen. These guys are my best infantry. Look pretty cool. They've got different shields. Nothing flashy, but they look pretty professional, pretty scary. And then I have four units of these Vlach spearmen. Pretty low tier spears, but you know, they should get the job done, hopefully. You know, they're there. And then I have, this is my backbone of my army, my main force. I have four units of frontiersmen. These guys look pretty cool. Lumberjacks, they're, you know, part-time warriors, part-time frontiersmen. So hopefully they help out in today's battle, get some good kills. I have two halberdiers, which are going to be really useful at taking out strategic choke points. And then I have three units of Serbian knights. These guys are awesome. Pretty good cav unit, pretty solid. Tier 2, pretty nasty. And then for the rest of my army, I actually have some of these guys. They're called Bashtiniks. Don't know, you know, how to pronounce it properly, but they're the ones with the flashy shield. So that's pretty much it from my army. Let's head over to Jackie Fish's army, and we will look at his. Oh, real quick, I do have some skirmishers here. These guys are like messengers. They quickly march to the emperor just to let him know that the Serbians are on their way. So they're just stationed here, just, you know, promising the men around them, like, oh, don't worry, there's a Serbian army marching, you know, towards us as we speak. Just hold out for him. But his army is mostly consisting of sergeants early period. He also has some sergeants in the high and late period. Let's see, what else has he got? He's got a lot of crossbows for the good old defense, some crossbow militia. Nothing flashy there, but you know, they are militia. And then over here, he's got this unit of, they're pretty cool. They're the men at arms. They have the Zweihander, the two-hander swords here. If you look at their uniforms, I think the modders need to go back and probably retouch their uniforms here. Maybe add some textures. I don't know. It just looks like they're wearing their dad's t-shirt or something, or like they've got a band t-shirt on. Like, oh, you know that Holy Roman Empire band? Yeah, they're so good. So yeah, it looks like a modern t-shirt is all I'm trying to say. So it looks kind of goofy. And then he's got some Pavi's spearmen. Pretty cool. I do like the Holy Roman Empire's spearmen there. And that's pretty much it for his force. I also want to show you the emperor. Look at this emperor. He don't care. Look at this guy. He don't care. He sticks out like a sore thumb, but you know, he's just that kind of personality. He's got nothing matches here. He's got a purple shirt with some nice steel armor there, but then he almost has like bronze armor on his, you know, for a helmet. Oh, look, you can see inside. And then he's got some blue feathers, and yeah, he's just like, hey, what's up, guys? I'm the emperor. I'm looking good. I don't know. It just doesn't match. And then he has some halberdiers, or mercenary Swiss halberdiers to defend the choke points. Alright, so I think we got plenty of time. I think this is going to be well timed, because by the time we finish these army comps, it's going to begin. But let me go ahead and show you the bombard shot here. So let me just fast forward real quick. Alright. Boom! Alright, that's pretty amazing. I gotta admit, that's amazing. For a mod that has no gunpowder, or for a game that has no gunpowder, for them to add gunpowder is pretty cool. Even though they're loading it up with, like, little bolts and stuff. Well, you know, whatever. Just use your imagination. But Burgundy, bringing some foot knightly retinue. He's got some crossbow sergeants. He has the Pavis spearmen, which are really good at holding the line. More foot knightly retinue. He's got some men-at-arms with their very nasty weapons and armor. And he's got more sergeants down here, which I believe is... well, actually, these are retinue. But I do believe he has some sergeants somewhere. Somewhere, I don't know. He's got some halberds over here too, and here's some handgunners. Those are going to be a real pain. Back here, he has some cav units like the men-at-arms, and here is his general. Let's move up to England, who's mostly... Look at all the cav units he's bringing. He's got the English king, and then he has some mounted sergeants, and he has some knightly retinue, and mostly mounted sergeants, it looks like. He is bringing a lot of retinue longbow and yeoman archers, and he's bringing some heavy billmen, two units of heavy billmen. For his main infantry, he's got some sergeants, foot knightly retinue, some men-at-arms. Again, looks like they're wearing their grandpa's t-shirt or something. And he's got some more. I think that's pretty much it for his force. So, oh, he's got some cheap spears in the middle here. So, all right, those are the armies. That's pretty much it. So let's start this. This is gonna be really cool. Like, this is a really good battle because it's so close. You're not gonna tell who's gonna win this one until the final couple seconds, minutes. Well, maybe minutes. It is extreme, like, down to the wire. So it should be a good one. Also, there's some pretty interesting tactics in this one as well. So we can see here that the Holy Roman Empire, they are preparing their troops, getting ready to hold the walls. Jackie Fish is going with a strategy where he sends up the cheaper troops first. That's usually, like, the standard strategy, because you don't necessarily want to give up the walls without a fight, because you want to try to activate these towers as long as possible. Because Total War Attila... Their arrow towers are ridiculous. The amount of... They're so OP. The range, the accuracy, the rate of fire. It's crazy. So, yeah, they can definitely rack up some kills. We do have a bit of a skirmish going on here. Crossbows v. crossbows. The Duchy of Burgundy. They're moving up their crossbows. Oh, yeah. Some good hits there. Oh, that guy got stabbed right in the face. Oh, man. That sucks. Gotta watch out for those bolts, man. They'll come for you. Alright, so the siege tower is still moving forward. Again, just keep track of the time. 10 minutes is when I can move forward. I'm just sitting there watching, enjoying the battle at this point. I'm also thinking about how I'm going to enter this settlement. Now, if we look here, the attackers are not using their artillery. They know better, because... I can't, you know, because Attila is Attila, and I can't use these siege towers because they're enemy siege towers. So once he takes the walls, you know, the siege towers are in place, I can't use them. I can only go through the gate. So I gotta make sure that there is a gate constantly open. Jackie Fish, because if the gates are gone, I don't know what I'm gonna do, because there's no way I can get my army inside. There's absolutely, because I didn't bring any artillery, so I can't knock down the walls. So yeah, hopefully Jackie Fish can hold the gate open for my reinforcements. But this is a pretty cool, epic scene right here. The siege tower is moving forward. That actually looks pretty good. That looks pretty cool, not gonna lie. So there they are, there they go, finally getting into position, and pretty soon they're gonna come storming through these siege towers. Let's get a good view here. Oh, this is an excellent view. Oh yeah, here they come, boys. Charge in and hold your ground. Soon, we will come. The Serbians, they will arrive. Just hold. At dawn, look east. All right, so we got more forces. Here comes the elite men-at-arms charging in. They're gonna be a huge problem for Jackie Fish's forces. He's also got more swordsmen coming in this way. It looks like he caught his crossbow sight by surprise, but he's got his sergeants close behind, so they're gonna try to fill in the gap and stop this massive invasion, this massive sieging force. And it doesn't look good for Jackie Fish. He's got some reserves over here. He definitely needs to send them in. I have my skirmishers this way. They're trying to help out a little bit. But skirmishers are actually pretty good in siege situations, so I don't want to throw them away. But I am going to try to keep them alive as much as possible and try to support Jackie as he tries to hold this front wall here. Come on, fire. Fire skirmishers. There they go. There they go. Alright. So let's see the hits here. Oh yeah, getting some good hits. Oh, that guy just got hit in the elbow. The back arm. He doesn't even care. Oh, this guy's dying over here with its with a javelin in its back there. So, pretty good start, I think. You know, Jackyfish just trying to hold on to those arrow towers, trying to get as many kills. Now, I think it's pretty obvious that he's going to lose this main wall, which is not great, but he doesn't really have a choice because he just doesn't have enough troops to hold back all these, you know, all the invading forces. But just a lot of colors and armor, shiny armor and colors on the battlefield. And we can see that Jackyfish's forces are already wavering to these guys. Pretty unfortunate. You can see back here, Jackyfish is holding back a massive horde of troops with one unit of sergeants. It's only a matter of time until they break. And look at the lag. Man, I'm dropping some frames there. Classic Attila. So well made. So well optimized. It's like, they're actually holding for a pretty long time. It's pretty crazy. There goes one of the towers. I think they captured it by just, you know, standing near it. He's got his footmen at arms capturing it. And what is up with this lag? My goodness. What's the deal with that? There's so many troops, I assume. Yeah, there's a lot of troops fighting in one area over here. But we can see here that Jackyfish is losing that main wall. And my skirmishers, I was trying to be pretty sneaky with them, putting them up on this wall and try to fire at the heavy buildmen here. But it really wasn't worth it because they're getting shot by archers and they don't really have a good angle to the enemy forces. So it's a pretty intense battle. It's kind of hard to tell who's who, but you know. Just turn on the HUD. You can see a little bit better. Here comes the heavy buildman, ready to flank around, attack Jackyfish's sergeants, early period sergeants. And I don't think they're going to be able to hold on for much longer. Everything has been wiped out. And just in a matter of minutes, Jackyfish's army is gone. Well, half of his army. He still has his elite force back in reserve. These guys, it's all about victory right here. If these guys can hold out and I can show up to save the day, then we're looking pretty good. It is close to 10 minutes, so pretty soon I'm going to move up my army. It still sucks. Like, looking back at this replay and seeing how Jackyfish he's really struggling to hold back these armies, it sucks that it just takes so long for my army to, you know, eventually move forward. That 10 minutes is the longest 10 minutes that I've ever experienced. Probably not really. Not really. A lot of arrows are crashing in. Getting a lot of friendly fire from his troops. But yeah, again, he's saving his ammo here. And I was eager to move forward my army because I wanted to take out these catapults if I had the opportunity. But he knows better, and he's going to go ahead and push forward. He's actually pushing all of his army inside the castle, and now they're gonna prepare their second wave of attack here against Jackyfish. Their second assault, I should say. Oh, he's got some troops fighting over here. Look at this. These early period sergeants, they do not stand a chance against these footmen at arms. Let's get some nice close-ups here of this fantastic battle. Oh, that guy just lost his head. That's a very common animation in this game. Oh, they're cheering. Look at them cheer. Look at that. They're like, huzzah. These guys, what are they doing? They're just standing here. They're not breaking. Oh, they are breaking, but they're like glitched out. They're like, nope. You got to watch us cheer. Oh, geez. There's another one losing his head. What is going on here? Why are they not breaking? They're so terrified that they're just going to stand here. Oh, there they go. Okay. There they go. All right. Whatever. You know, you do your thing, breaking soldiers. Alright, so now they're moving up their cav just to be safe, protecting their artillery. I think I can move now pretty soon. Oh man, it's got to be close. I'm pretty sure it started at about 50 minutes. So we're down to 40 now. And if we look here, the attacking forces, they're now forming up their heavy buildmen. and they're gonna prepare their second assault. Now, the archers are really, really good in this situation because they're really gonna pepper down the defenses and just soften up those troops. So let's see what they do here. Obviously, just by looking at their formation, they're gonna go with a very slow approach. They're gonna try to kill as many as possible before actually engaging their infantry, which I think it could be good, but it could also be bad. Let's look at the point of view here of these sergeants. Now, it could be good because you're killing a lot of troops from afar, using your arrows, using your bows, but Jackie Fish is so heavily outnumbered that they could easily just rush him down and just attack on all flanks with the massive amount of infantry that they have left over. Man, these guys are just, what are they doing? They're like constantly looking back. Look at them. Is there someone behind me? It's like they can hear me talking. They're like, is someone talking over us? What's going on here? What's going on? I have no idea. Why? I think it has something to do with the arrows flying over and they're looking back at the arrows. I don't know. They just look confused. They look so confused. They're like, what's the command here? What are we supposed to do against such reckless hate? Let's see what's going on here. Lots of arrows coming in. That's what's going on. Let's see. I think they're going. Yep. Oh, that's disgusting. They're going for the men-at-arms. They're going for the more expensive unit, which is always wise. So hopefully Jackie Fish, he can retreat his force here and get him, behind a building or something like that to protect him from the arrow fire. And then you can see here that he has taken some of these arrow towers. They've lost a lot of good men taking these. I think this was from the gate alone, taking out a bunch of those billmen and halberds. That is crazy. So that's what I'm saying. Those arrow towers are so deadly, and nobody was defending these. Nobody was defending these arrow towers, and they lost like half a unit. They're too strong. They are too strong. We might get a charge here. Maybe. Maybe not. I'm not really sure. Yes, do not go quietly. Alright, let's see if they charge in here. Come on. No, they're just holding their ground. They're going to continue to fire with their arrows. Look at all the blood on the battlefield. These poor troops have nowhere to go. Oh, the general almost getting caught out here. Looks like the general was going for a charge on the crossbows, but Jackie Fish was paying attention. And look at the emperor. Look at him fighting in style. That ridiculous outfit. Get out of there, man. So, unfortunately, he does get his general out of there. Yeah, Jackie Fish trying to push forward his Pavi spearman, but he just doesn't get there in time, and the general's going to make it out alive. That was really risky. You got to be careful with your generals. You don't want to lose them like that. Oh, geez, here comes the catapult fire, burning these men alive. Very, very unfortunate for them. Very bad luck. So, they're now using their catapults, and what is this? Finally, I'm moving up my army, so I've got a fresh, healthy army ready to go, but will I get there in time? That is the question. It looks like he's gonna defend this outer wall with this massive amount of cav here, so we'll see how effective that is. Now, most of this cav is pretty crappy because they're mounted sergeants. He does have a couple good units in the mix, like a knightly retinue, which are pretty good at, you know, fighting, doing well, pretty good as a cav unit. Let's see what's going on here. Still just a standoff over here. He's just using those archers, using the artillery fire. He's got a huge clump of troops on this side. So what I'm going to do here is actually push up my skirmishers and try to get some kills from afar. Oh, we can see that he's firing the artillery in this position, trying to soften up these Pavi spearmen. And my skirmishers are doing pretty good. Obstructed. Looks like there's these forces are just in the way, so they're not firing. That's unfortunate. He should probably move forward. Let's see, he's actually moving back. So yeah, this is this is definitely some patience from the attacking side. That is for sure. Oh, here comes another volley, another shot here. Oh yes, getting a good hit both on my skirmishers there and on the Pavi. Actually, I don't think he got any kills there, but it was really close to my skirmishers. Now he's moving forward his Pavi's his spears. And my skirmishers should be able to fire now. So, yes, they are letting loose their javelins. And they... Oh, there we go. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep throwing them. Let's do this. Throw. There they go. They're doing some damage. I'm softening them up. And they're going to charge into the spears. The spears are going to hold their ground. Oh, this is what we're talking about. Nice infantry charge. Finally, he's attacking. I hate when players are just super passive and they use up all their archer fire. Let's see what's going on over here. Nope, there. Oh, look at this. Is just dirty. I mean, Jackie Fish is already at a huge disadvantage, and they're using their handgunners to fire down at these spears. I mean, it's the right thing to do, but dang. You know, but dang. Oh, jeez. Look, they're dropping like flies. That penetration, man. The gunpowder is just so nasty. So that fight's still going on. We do have a bit of a fight going on over here. He went to charge my my archers, and most of my cav was focused on this flank. So I decided to charge in my general and take on his knights here. So we do. Here's my general, actually. You can see his crown there. It's actually the Grand Prince of Serbia. But yeah, we're fighting off some men-at-arms from Burgundy. A pretty solid unit, but I do have some spears nearby and some infantry charging forward. You can see my Vlach spearmen. There they go. Quickly support the general in a time of need. I'm also firing some archers into the area, which is a little risky because you don't want to, you know, accidentally strike down our, you know, our general. So, I don't know. It's worth the risk because these guys are so good. I don't want my general to die. And look at that. My general's losing a lot, but thankfully the spears, you know, they showed up on time. So a pretty good fight there. Let's go ahead and see what's going on back at Jackie Fish's point of view. You can see that his spears are charging in. I accidentally misclicked here, and my skirmishers decided to charge into melee. I was trying to go after his cav, but his cav were a lot closer earlier. So actually, there they go. Now his cav's moving in. Yeah, I don't know. I guess my skirmishers just had a mind of their own. They just decided to charge in, kill these heavy billmen, which is kind of helping out Jackie Fish. But look at this. Jackie Fish is just insta-breaking these troops. That was truly amazing. I mean, from one unit of Pavi's spearmen, massive break. I don't know if it's because of my skirmishers. I think he got a lot of friendly fire from his catapults, which does not help out. And now he's sending down some sergeants to finish the job and get rid of this flank. Because remember, I need one of these gates to be open or I cannot come inside. So Jackie Fish, he's going to charge out and reclaim it. More artillery coming in. Watch out. Looks like it wasn't too devastating there. There we go. Charging in the sergeants. Oh, and then my general was killed on the battlefield. Look at this. Look at this. Even though I had a bunch of support back here, lots of frontiersmen, lots of spearmen, my general gets wiped out and it's over. And these guys are still going strong. The men at arms are still going strong. Now, to be honest, the terrain here was really difficult to maneuver around because of these rocks right here. So you can see it kind of funnels in, and that really helps these troops. So I need to try to get some infantry to try to flank around and get behind the cav unit. I really wasn't expecting them to hold back so many troops for so long. So this is really delaying my army, and it's not so good. We can see that his cav forces are now behind me. He just doesn't want to engage just yet. I think he's just trying to distract me and slow me down, and it is working. Now, we're already at a huge loss because of the death of the general, but we can see, you know, let's see what happens here. Let's see what happens. So there goes the Emperor, taking out some of the catapults, which were getting super close to the front line. I think he prematurely sent over the catapults, didn't realize that he was losing on this flank, and his troops were on the run. You can see that Jackie Fish's army doing a pretty good job of wiping out this flank. I was really impressed. I was like, wow. I mean, that's like 90% of the English infantry just gone like that. I don't know if it's because they lost a lot of morale trying to take those arrow towers or what. But Jack, you know, I can't complain. Jackie Fish doing a great job. He's moving in his Pavi spearmen. And his general is kind of getting surrounded right here, which is not good. He does not want to lose his general. That is a big no-no. I've already lost my general, so we can't lose. Uh-oh. Enemy general dead. What? Oh, the English king has been wiped out. I guess I guess he was fighting over here. Yeah, that's gonna be huge for the morale. And now his troops are on the run. Jackie Fish doing a great job here. He's gonna continue to run down these archers, but he's gotta keep moving his general. He's gotta be careful. Honestly, he should fall back his general, I think. But he's gonna go for a charge here. Oh, that was nasty. Great charge into the footmen at arms. Fantastic charge. But he's got to get him out of the fight because there's going to be a lot of archers focusing down their fire over at that flank. Actually, these longbows. Oh, there they go. They're moving. I think they're going to move a little bit closer. But the Emperor, he don't care. I mean, look at that outfit. He don't care. He's just going in. Going in for the kill. Here comes the Pavi Spears. They're a very slow moving unit. So they're trying to get over there as quick as possible. And we can see the English archers here about to... What are they firing at? I'm not really sure. What are they firing at? There's nothing over there. There's absolutely nothing over there. It's a cool screenshot. Let me take that. All right, let's exit out of this view. Yeah, they're actually going to turn around. Oh, look at they're firing on the move. That's dirty. So yeah, they're turning around. They're firing at the Emperor. And this unit of footmen at arms, they are almost wiped out. That was some nice aggressive play by Jackie Fish. But he needs to get his general out of there or it's going to be focused down. Or he's going to be focused down by those archers. Let's see. Come on. So get in front of the general. Don't let him fall. Here comes the general. He's desperately charging. He's desperately charging. Come on, hop over the dead bodies. Dude, charge in. What are you doing? Get over there. This is now or never. He's going to silence these archers. There they go. There goes that purple general. All hail the purple general. All right, so over here we also have a cab battle going on. So let me do normal speed. I don't know why I slowed it down. But we missed a little bit of a charge there. But yeah, nice cav battle. And there goes Jackie Fish's general. Unfortunately, he falls. He dies to the hands of the retinue longbowmen. But I am wiping out what's left of this cav unit because they're mostly just mounted sergeants, which they're no match to my Serbian knights. So they're going to wipe them out pretty quickly there. There they go, running for their lives. And that is going to wrap up. Oh, wait, no, there's another cav unit. He was able to sneak one of his cav units around and attack my archers. I'm going to use this unit to try to absorb the charge. That was not good, but that's okay. That's okay. Just hold them in place, and then I'm going to send my cav over as reinforcements. Come on, form up and charge. Why are you not charging? Yeah, so I'm not even close to getting back inside. Oh, look at this. How is he doing this? He's just running past all my infantry, pulling out of situations and charging into new situations. So he's going after my very vulnerable archers. My archers are going to hold their ground. They should have enough men to take out these cav units. And yep, sure enough, they break. And that is going to wrap it up with the English cav. Thank you. So since Jackie Fish has claimed this section over here, he's going to quickly reconquer it, retake it over. And that is going to be my entrance right here. So now I am on the move. I have a lot of cav moving that way. So things are getting pretty crazy on this side. You can see a massive assault over here. And he is holding with his Pavi's spears and his Swiss halberds, his mercenary Swiss. Look at that roasted tree in the back there. That's pretty cool. I don't know. It just looks cool. It's like Minas Tirith or something. And then we can see that he's got a lot of troops just waiting in reserve over here. He's constantly getting harassed by those gunners here. Again, he's being super passive, using up every single bit of his ammo to try to soften up this defense. But he's wasting time. He is losing time because pretty soon the Serbians, they are going to show up. My army is going to come here and attack and hopefully defend this settlement. Because Jackie Fish, he is running out of troops. As you can tell, he's got about 1, 2, 3, 4 units. That's it. 4 units. But he is down a general as well. I am also down a general. So our morale is pretty crap. They've lost one general, but they still have another general alive. So this is the last general on the battlefield. Let's just enjoy this fight right here. pretty intense. The balance of power is now even. Well, I think it's slightly in favor of the attackers. But when the battle started, the balance of power was pretty clearly in favor of the attacking armies, which it should be, because defenders should have less money, which they do. They've got about 15 to... I think they have 25% less money. So this is a major issue right here. You can see some troops breaking in the back, which is pretty good. But I need to get over here as quick as possible. We've got some spears kind of holding this gate over here. Obviously, he doesn't want to give up this gate, so I can't get troops over there. You can see my cav. Jackyfish has reclaimed the gate. I'm now charging in my cav, and I'm going to do a very important charge on his longbows, which are currently harassing my troops on the outer walls. So here we go. Charge those knights in. Come on, quickly. What the heck? All right, so like half the unit just turned there. Oh, that would be so cool if they like fell off the walls and just like, oh, somebody catch me. I'm falling, catch me, catch me. There they go. They're going to break pretty quickly. The cav charge is just so dirty. Just pinned them to the walls and now just slaughtering them. And I'm using the cav more as an infantry unit. I'm just kind of waiting here, waiting for a good opportunity to strike. You can see that he has his halberds over here kind of protecting this area. There's really no point in me wasting my cav and trying to charge over there. You know, I don't want to charge this way because he'll... I mean, there's nowhere to go and those halberdiers are going to slaughter me. And now we've got a fight over here going on between the Pavis spears of Burgundy and the Swiss halberds, the mercenary Swiss halberds. Look at those pants. Look at those pants. Those are some good pants. I think he can be shot though. He's like out in the open. So you can see he's setting up his gunners down here to fire down at Jackie Fish's troops. Let's see how devastating this is. Because I think over time, Jackie Fish should win this engagement. Oh, but with the support of the crossbows. Yeah, those are crossbows, actually. There they go. Yeah, they're doing a lot of damage to this unit. You can see the blood just dripping down this hill. He's actually falling back, which is pretty wise. I think Jackie Fish, he needs to move back, get behind the building, protect his men from those crossbows. Oh, what do we got here? Handgunners now moving forward. Let's see if they get a shot here. No. Yep, here they go, here they go. Oh my god. The front line there. Oh, that was nasty. Lost so many halberdiers in one volley. Gunners are just so ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. And then I noticed that he's moving troops this way down the street. So I decided to dismount my knights and put them on foot to defend this choke point because I don't want to lose, you know, a proper path to get to the town center. I am now moving knights up this way to the town center because Jackie Fish, he is running out of troops over here. He is crumbling, only a matter of time until these troops get tired and they break to the sheer size of the Burgundy forces. There's like archers in the front line, you see that? There's like a couple archers just firing point blank. So yeah, this is just a huge cluster of troops here, tightly packed together, desperately fighting for that choke point. And Jackie Fish, did his troops break there? I think so. I think Jackie Fish's troops broke trying to chase down those Pavis spearmen. But now Jackie Fish, he's down to his one unit of sergeants. This is a late period sergeant unit. Oh, rep in peace. Those archers, man, just tearing up Jackie Fish's forces. I feel really bad for him. And I'm trying to get my army inside the town center. You can see I've got some spearmen finally making it to the town center. And just right on time. Right on time I get inside here. And here comes my cav. I'm charging in my cav as well. Just trying to support him on this front. Trying to break him because we've seen a lot of breaking on this side. And I want to get to those archers. I want to get to the general. Oh, I'm falling back. So why am I falling back? Get back in there. Keep attacking. Take him out, boys. So a pretty intense fight there. And what? Wow, his unit is wavering. Look at this. His unit of late sergeants are wavering after a couple volleys of Arch. Now, please keep in mind that he lost his general and he's got a very small army here, but we're now charging in because here they come, trying to take the town center. My spears are doing everything they can to hold them back. Obviously, my spears are not as good as fighters compared to the spears he has here and the knightly retinue he has fighting in this big spot here. But unfortunately, Jackie Fish's sergeants are breaking, and now, they're going to lose hope here because the flank has been exposed. They're now firing fire arrows to try to break the morale of our troops. Here comes my knights. I'm going to try to slow them down here. Actually, I'm just going to run right past them because I don't want my knights to get caught in between that. And here we go. I'm going to charge in my knights here. Oh, yeah. There we go. Nice charge on the flank of this huge blob. So that was really helpful there. That should kind of break their spirits. But, man, they're just getting hit hard from arrows. And, just look at that. The endless amount of arrows. It is a little ridiculous. Maybe we should add a max limit on archers. But we can see here that he's now sending over forces. This is Burgundy sending over their foot knightly retinue. He's got a couple reserves just waiting for the rest of my army to show up. You can see here I've got some elite troops, my frontiersmen, getting close to the town center. And he's also pushing up his halberdiers. Actually, they're getting close. They're just kind of staying put as of right now. All right, let's head back over to this fight here. I did get a hammer and anvil on his pavis. We missed it, but this cav unit that I charged in, I actually went back and charged the pavis that were closing in on Jackie Fish. Oh, here we go. I'm going to get another hammer and anvil. Jackie Fish. Oh, wait, no, the pavis are breaking. Oh, that's so good to see. Now I'm just charging in my knights to support Jackie Fish because his halberdiers are breaking as well. There goes my knights just pouring through. Look at that, like King Theoden going through the Uruk-hai. Oh, the cringy analogies. but we are breaking a couple, and he's using fire arrows in this area. So that is not good for the morale, because not only does it hurt the morale of your enemies, but it also hurts the morale of your own troops. There we go. Excellent. We're pushing in. And now I have my halberds in position. And we're going to be able to hold on for a little bit longer. Look at this. My forces have finally made it. And he's going to close off this gap. And now he has three units of swordsmen blocking off this entrance. I have one unit of my knights just kind of protecting this choke point in case he tries to charge in and attacks this side. We're still trying to take out the forces over here. You can see that they're slowly just cutting through our defenses. But thanks to the reserves, we should be able to push them back. There's that charge, that nasty charge. These are my elite auxiliaries here. Yeah, push them back. And I believe, oh yes, we're actually attacking the handgunners. This is huge. We got to take them out if we're going to win this one because they do so much damage. And I'm going to go ahead, run past the enemy forces and just go for those handgunners. I don't even care about the infantry here because they're not as important. I need to take out those handgunners. It's the only way we're going to win this one. I think that we got a small resistance over here preventing my swords from marching down after those handgunners. Come on, push down that hill. Gotta take it. Here comes more forces coming in to try to take the town center. They actually just ran right through my knights, my dismounted knights, my Serbian knights, and they're actually gonna attack the flank here. I'm gonna turn my forces around to meet them in the town center, in the courtyard. So a very nasty fight for this courtyard. And I have my halberdiers doing a pretty good job. Still very healthy. They haven't lost a single soldier in their unit. They're still 160 strong. They're exhausted though, because I have been running my troops. And now I'm flanking around the one soldier he sent back this way to try to stop my horde of reinforcements. So it's mostly my frontiersmen taking on the foot knightly retinue. Come on, charge in, man. The balance of power is still right where it was at the beginning of this battle. Still in favor of the attackers. I still have some reserves back here. Got the Bashtinks. Bashtinks. There they go. Now they're charging in. Here's this really cool fight. Now we got him surrounded. I closed in the jaws here. And the Foot Knightly Retinue fighting around so many of my troops. We are defeating his forces that showed up as reinforcements. And now we can properly defend. I'm cutting down his handgunners. So they are no longer an issue. So I'm going to send back my auxiliary swordsmen. Get them back to the town center. Because that is our only hope. We have to defend at the town center. Now it's really just down to my halberds. Jackie Fish, this is his last unit of sergeants, his late period sergeants. But I don't really expect these guys to break through my forces anytime soon. The archers, though, are not really helping out, really softening up my troops. Let's get some close-ups here of this very intense battle line. Let's see what's going on over on this side. We do have... Well, okay, this is really interesting. So I was actually able to get one of my troops up this siege tower, but I have no idea how it happened. I think I told all of my forces to click, or I clicked all of my forces and just to charge in this area, but some of my spearmen decided to go up the siege tower. I don't know why. I have no idea why, but I am holding back his Pavi spearmen over here with my my very cheap Vlach spearmen. Yeah, so they're not going to win that one. Oh, and here comes the Halberdier unit that was waiting in reserve. Again, trying to take out my forces. And I noticed he was out of position here. So I'm going to flank around with my Frontiersmen. And get behind him. There we go. Somewhat behind him. I still have more troops over here. Which I'm probably going to have to flank around this way and attack the backs of the halberds over here. But I really like the position we're in. We should be able to overwhelm them with numbers. But halberdiers, they're just so ridiculous. They're so broken. They're so good. Here we go. We're retreating the Serbian auxiliary swordsman back up on this hill. My dismounted knights here, they are falling back, defending the other flank. And now I've got most of my troops defending this choke point. And look at this. They've got a lot of troops breaking here. This is such a it looks like the balance of power is shifting. Well, I don't know. It still kind of looks the same. But if we look at the kills here, we have 400 more troops. But his troops are more elite. So he has more skilled troops. So I don't know. It's still really close. And we are just wiping out his forces over here. We're getting tons of kills. And I believe Jackie Fish's army has been wiped out. So it's all down to my army to win this one. Here comes another charge. He's got more reserves coming up this way. So I need to send up more troops. Send up my halberds. They are exhausted, but they must fight. And look at them marching over the conquered dead here. Come on, quickly form up. Form up. These are my troops breaking from the battle. They've just seen too much action. They've had enough. They're no longer going to fight. Now I'm going to form and slowly march into position because I don't want to get out of position. I want to make sure I'm in a solid position, solid formation, so I can hold back these troops properly. There we go. Stab that guy. Come on. Yeah, there you go. Oh, and look at this. He's just charging into my halberdiers. This is excellent. Keep stabby. Stab. Stabby, stabby. Stabby, stabby. There we go. Oh, geez. He's just trying to break through with brute force here. Not gonna happen. There's another wave of troops just running into my wall of halberds. An entire unit has perished. So yeah, we broke through. He was trying to sneak through some halberds, but they broke. And unfortunately, my halberds on this side have broken. and I'm down to this one unit of auxiliary swordsmen, and he is just pushing through and trying to reclaim the settlement. Here comes his general. His general is going to do so much damage to my halberdiers. And now, finally, I broke the infantry that was slowing me down this way, so I'm going to charge in what I have left. And he's actually going to charge in. Look at this. This is so risky to do with your general. And, oh, such a good charge there. But we need to cut down this general. Kill him now. If we can kill him, then this will be a much easier victory. A more easy victory. Easier. Whatever. Whatever. But the general is at half health after those very devastating charges. But they were also very devastating to his own unit. Let's see. Come on. Come on. Just keep attacking. Oh, God. Those charges, man. That is disgusting. What can we do against such reckless hate? So they're going to fall back once again. And I'm just going to keep closing in. I don't want to just sit there and let them, you know, charge me to death. I need to close in, take out that general. And now my halberdiers, who are so... just, they've been holding on for so long. They are about to be outflanked by this wall of angry Pavi spearmen. So there they go. They're going to get behind me. Not good. Not good at all. I've pretty much killed these archers, so I'm going to turn around, focus my attention. Look at the captain. He's like, turn! Turn it! He just got knocked out. I don't think he's dead. He's going to get back up. But my halberds do need to turn around. They need to protect their flank. There he goes. He got back up. There he goes. He's like, turn and fight! Don't leave me! Fight with me! So we broke the archers. Now I'm going to focus all of my attention on these Pavi spears. Did we kill the general? No, the general's still alive, but I've got a unit of knights flanking around here, trying to close in, trying to go after that general. So this battle is just all over the place. And here we go. Here we go. My frontiersman going to take out the general. Come on. Take him out. He's so low. Look at that. He is so low. He's so Han Solo. Oh, fire arrows coming in. I'm now using fire arrows to try to break the enemy. Break their morale. There is some major wavering right there. There we go. There we go. The general is wavering. You can see his icon is flashing. That means he's wavering. And my knights were able to break through there. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a good way to kill a general. That is a good start to this battle. Well, you know, not a start, but it's a good thing that happened in the battle. But unfortunately, he still has a ton of troops. They still have 800. They actually outnumber us now. How is that even possible? So they've just been really... Oh, look at this. I forgot to show you this. This one unit of halberdiers, even though it was surrounded, broke two of my units. That's just what happens when you lose a general. Your troops just start to break. Just out of nowhere. Even though they have the advantage, they just break. So his halberds, man, they are just doing an excellent job, even though they were outnumbered. But it looks like... Well, it's pretty... Well, this is going to be a pretty close fight. But they're very depleted. They should break at any moment now. Alright, and then, unfortunately, his swarm of troops over here are breaking through my frontiersmen. We took out the general. His bodyguard, though, are still fighting. Yes, they are fleeing. So there goes my frontiersmen. There's a small group of troops here. Two of them are wavering, and then we have one halberdier unit. So on this side, my halberdiers are taking on more foot knightly retinue. Just seems like this guy has an endless amount of troops, and now the spears are pushing in after my archers. And it's not looking good. But you know, honestly, if we just get a bird's eye view of this battle, we can see here that I still have a ton of troops. I am breaking the halberdiers. Any second now, they're going to break. I have more archers pushing forward, which they still have a decent amount of ammo. I mean, this archer unit still has almost full ammo. But unfortunately, they're stuck in melee. And now my halberdiers are about to be outflanked here. I'm going to try to turn around really, really fast and take on these footmen at arms. Hold your ground. Here comes his unit of halberdiers. And we actually break them. Look at that, a massive breakdown. Units are just breaking left and right because all of the generals are dead. There's really no proper command going on in this battle. So what I'm gonna do here is actually fall back my halberds and get away from his halberds because I wanna reform and try to hold them off as long as possible because it really, any second now, these guys can break. And I don't want to lose them because they're my last solid infantry. And look at this. This halberdier unit has been breaking for like a minute now. They have been wavering for a minute. And my troops are still fighting them. Like, this is, it's insane. Like, they've killed so many of my troops. I'm now down to 60. I'm at half strength with this unit. So I'm trying to take them off the battlefield, but they just won't die. They fight to the end, even though it shows them as wavering. And let's see, my archers are getting over here. I mean, this is such an amazingly close battle. My archers are gonna have to hold back these Pavi spears, but I don't think they're gonna have enough. Yep, look at them charging in. Yeah, they're gonna break them. And here comes the. I went to this corner to hold with my halberdiers against the kingdom or the duchy of Burgundy, their halberdiers. Yeah, it doesn't look like anyone's really dying here, so this is good. You know, it's keeping them occupied. Archers are trying to fire at the spear unit. It's really just a desperate situation. Finally, we broke the halberds, so we're going to be able to move up my infantry. But really, this is what's left of my elite infantry. I'm now retreating my archers this way. I'm not going to engage. I need to fire as many arrows as I can to try to, you know, to try to soften them up before I engage them. But they've pretty much they've taken the town center. So I don't know how much time that it takes for them to win it just by conquering it. But I am waiting for reinforcements this side. I've got some spearmen that are trying to get into position. They were way out of position early on in this battle. So here we go. My Bastiniks charge! Fight the good fight with Serbia and the Holy Roman Empire. Alright, my halberdier is still fighting over here. There's still hope. As long as I have halberdiers, there is still hope. Let's see what's going on here. My spears finally getting inside the fortress, trying to quickly get them over there. Unfortunately, the last unit of my my infantry, they are breaking. My sworded infantry, they are breaking from the battle. They're wavering. There's just too many of them. I mean, they've only lost one guy. Man, those Pavi spears are so good. They're just so heavily armored with those riot shields. So yeah, I'm falling back, and now I'm pushing in my spears. Yeah, doesn't look great. I don't think I have anything here. So yeah, that's pretty much the battle. And really, look what it's down to. He's got one unit of halberdiers. He's got two units of these Pavi spearmen, and he's got a artillery crew. That's it. That is it. Now, he does have one unit over here, but I'm sure they're very, like, they could break. They're very timid at this point because I think they've already broken during the battle. So this was so close. Such a tough fight. I think Jackyfish and I, we did pretty good. I think we did, like, considering the situation, like, how conservative they were and, like, how they had all these elite troops and they just sat back and fired their guns at our defenses. I think we did a pretty good job of recovering. It was looking pretty rough at the start, and we almost came back and seized victory today. But I'm just going to go ahead and fast forward here through the rest of this battle and get you straight to the end results. All right, guys, so here we are. Very, very close fight, but just wasn't there. We're just so close. But my cav here getting a decent amount of kills. I think one unit, let's see, 282, which is probably the most kills out of anyone. My really good infantry did a pretty good job. My frontiersmen not doing so great. Actually, you know, 420, no scope. 360 doing a great job here. My halberdier 420. That is crazy. I mean, the halberdiers are just so ridiculous. And then looking at the enemy armies, look at this. 212 with the handgunners, 313 with the foot men-at-arms, 236, 154, 150. I mean, that's a ton of kills. This halberdier is not doing well. They did really well. But yeah, that's pretty much it for my army. Here's Jackie Fish's army. Let's see who did the best here. 257 with his sergeants. His crossbow's doing all right. His halberds did okay, except for this one, only getting 13 kills, which is really bad. And then looking at England, who got 388, 231 with his footmen at arms. Footmen at arms are just nasty. They're really, really good. His catapult's not getting a ton of kills. His archers, just look at all of them getting over 100 kills. That's really what killed us right there, is those archers. And his halberd, his billman actually not doing that great. So that's going to wrap up today's battle. This is really fun doing the reinforcement thing. Definitely going to try it again. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like, a comment, a share. And if you haven't subscribed, be sure to hit that subscribe button for more epic battles. So thanks, guys, and I will see you next time.